trot her right out of it.
When you come through there, just think forward, 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 kind of as soon as she gets her nose.
Yeah, do you feel that too as she trips?
Huh?
Is that because she's kind of stumbling? Or?
No, she's not stumbling too bad right now, actually. How fast you got her to trot off and how quickly you released. You released a little bit sooner.
And she clipped on the fence a little bit better too.
Same thing again right here. Five bend. Right there. Release.
There. And the other thing too, if you're not picking up on both reins right there, because when you're pushing her through, you've kind of got her outside a little bit and her inside. If you're not picking up on both reins, that'll help her move forward because she's not moving into the pressure when you release that. Slide down, bend her towards me. And wait on her a second or two. Wait there, rub on her, hold on. Alright. Reach back, rub behind the saddle. Alright. Cinch feel pretty tight?
Yeah, I think it feels good. How's it look to you?
Breath a bit before we start. So squeeze, sit forward a little bit. Kind of tip forward. So sensitive, they can feel a fly land on them and twitch just that part of their skin. I mean, it's kind of the same thing as like your jerk brother or cousin or whoever it was who runs up to you and slaps you on the back as hard as they can. It's like, Jesus, man, what the hell? good to see you too. Now go back to the other side of the family.
Right.
I do a lot of rubbing on horses. Like I said, not a lot of flapping. Then I just walk her off again.
I'm glad you pointed that out because I'm not.
A lot. lot of people do it too. It's especially big.
I'm on. I mean, she can clearly tell the difference between when you're on and when I'm on. So.
What, with her energy?
Yeah.
No, she's just smart enough to know that she might need to conserve it a little bit.
Oh, okay. She's like, oh, we're working with this guy now. He might not.
Yeah.
He might
not enter. Strength, but it's not like yeah, if I was going to speed you up right now, which side would you want to be on?
Well, this side's okay.
just like last time. You only got to go a stride or two in the beginning,
uh-huh.
And then you're just going to fly down and bend her down.
Make sure you really kind of relax your lower back, too. I don't know if you just bounce.
Go ahead, Ben. You got a lot farther that time.
Yep.
Like I said, I think it's going to build pretty quickly once you start getting your confidence back.
Yeah, well, that's it. That's it. And I know what to expect.
Yeah, exactly.
I think, you know, when it's that that time between anticipating her cancer and, like, when she's actually trotting.
Yeah.
Because I anticipate it and then it doesn't happen.
Plus.
And you're like, oh, okay, when's it going to happen? And then it does.
Yeah.
So it's almost better if it just kind of happens then because then I know. But then it's like.
Yeah, like I said, it'd be a lot easier for you if she just kind of hop up and roll up because that long extended trot.
Yes.
While you're trying to get ready for it, you kind of sit down and you sort of bouncing a little bit.
Exactly.
But like I said, just kind of sharpen the gas pedal up a little bit by, even right here, when you ask her to walk up and you ask her to go up in the truck,
yep.
Squeeze, click twice, and if she's not up there, you reach back and give her a little dab. You know? And if you sharpen it up there, you should get it sharper at a low, too.
Yeah, I can.
You know, that's a kind of nasty place to ride that.
Yeah, and it seems like a long time, so I'm like, gosh.
You're kind of getting ready for that lope where you're just going to relax and you need the most because you need to do it in the front.
Thank you.
hold her face. Don't hold her face. See, getting mad at her. Yeah. There you go. You know, she's kind of quieted down with her head already there. She was unhappy. I didn't think she'd go that far with it. She's being a bit lazy with you. Out here.
kind of kicking the colt's butt with this sort of stuff. You know, our horses only had a couple of rides on them.
But this isn't about fear for her.
She just wants to do anything.
She thinks she can get away with bullying you a little bit. She's kind of getting lazy, and you know, the round pen doesn't help. Just, go somewhere.
this trying to trot off isn't being really productive. I'm not getting far anymore.
Whereas opposed to the lope, when she loped off, you know, my hand was up here and she was on a nice new train, so she figured out real quick and figured out what I needed to be doing. When I finally just started to back up that walk again, she went too quick. I slowed down, bent her down. Oh, I think it really worked to bend her in the defensive bunch right there to kind of get her to think, you know, this isn't what he wants right now, because I keep getting interrupted and it's getting to be hard work too. It's getting to be hard work to go full, at least. Walking off the end of the bar. Bend her down, walk her around the other way. Yeah, I know. Life's tough if you want to pretend to be tough. Oh. When I'm here, I'll just jump up on her and try and get rid of that sort of attitude, you know, because I don't like to see that. I have no call for it.
No, right?
That'd be real attentive.
That'd be good.
That'd be real attentive for those 2 hours, you know?
Better.
Well, yeah, she's still not very balanced at a lope. She's gotten a bit better, but she's very heavy. She's going to lean a little bit more around her than she was in the past. She's bigger and she's going out the edge. I'm trying to bend her into the fence right there, though. I caught her right off out of really low. There you go. Now you're getting some forward movement. She's in kind of a faster trot. She's putting some effort into what she's doing. Not that we would eventually like to just be able to trot her around in a nice lazy one, but for the day, we want to get her forward a bit. Bend her into the fence again, really look over that shoulder and drive there. There you go, feel that little pop in the air?
feels better to lope on.
If she could go to like 4 or 4:25 maybe,
yeah,
then I could do that, and then I could bump up lessons with you.
Yeah.
That